Informed consent stands for the rights of patients and is a key part of the clinical research process. In this module, we will review the process of obtaining informed consent and turning patients into clinical trial subjects. Let's take a look at the definition of informed consent. Informed consent is the process through which researchers provide the necessary information to potential participants so that a knowledgeable decision can be made about whether the individuals wish to take part in a research study. This is an ongoing process that begins with initial recruitment of subjects and continues after the initial oral or written agreement form from an individual to participate in a research study. Upon getting familiar with all the information related to the clinical trial that has the option to join, the patient can decide whether he or she wants to participate in a study. If they agree to do so, an administrative procedure is completed and the patient becomes a clinical trial subject. Let's review the differences between being a patient and being a subject. 1. As we already mentioned, when a person volunteers to participate in a research trial, his or her status changes from patient to subject. An individual who participates in a clinical trial, either as a recipient of the investigational products or as a control. 2. Subjects may not be receiving standard of care as patients do. The risks related with the treatment may be higher. 3. Documentation for subjects is more extensive than regular clinical documentation. 4. The subject is the ultimate decision maker and must have complete information to assure his participation remains voluntary. So, as we discussed, obtaining an informed consent is the necessary first step towards participating in a clinical trial. But what are the different stages of the process of obtaining informed consent? As part of the informed consent process, the consent form is designed to provide information to potential subjects about a research study so they can make an informed decision about their participation. The use of a form to document the consent process is required unless specifically waived by the IRB. One of the most common reasons for delay in IRB approval is an incomplete, inaccurate, and/or unclear consent form document. Step 1 of the process is introduction. Step 2, explanation. Step 3, comprehension. Step 4, question and answer session. And step 5, obtaining consent. There are certain population groups that might be exposed to risks when participating in a clinical study more than others. Those are called vulnerable populations. Minors or special adult populations who are being recruited as research subjects may be compromised in their ability to provide truly informed and voluntary consent. Therefore, those groups require special safeguards to ensure that their rights are protected in the informed consent process.